a great day when I get to stop by Mambo, and today is made even more special. It's the purpose of honoring one of our Packer greats by designating the Bart Starr Memorial Bridge right here in Green Bay. Bart Starr obviously was an exceptional man both on and off the field. He, alongside the great Vince Lombardi, propelled our Green Bay Packers and Lambeau Field into sports history. You know, sporting a list of remarkable achievements. Think of this: 6 divisional championships, 5 NFL championship titles, 2 Super Bowl victories, and the first 2 Super Bowls really put Green Bay on the map as Title Town USA. Bart Starr is the only player in NFL history to lead a team into 3 consecutive league championships, and still to this day holds a record for the highest postseason passer rating of any quarterback. 2-time Super Bowl MVP, an inductee to the Pro Football, Packer, Wisconsin Athletic Halls of Fame, and one of only 6 Packers that have their numbers retired. The awards speak for themselves. Beyond the field, this is really important. Bart and his wife, Cherry, gave back to the community, and we share in the belief that our kids are our greatest investments and that every kid should have the opportunity to reach their full potential. The two co-founded Rawhide Youth Services to serve at-risk kids and started Star Children's Fund in partnership with the Vince Lombardi Cancer Foundation. By all accounts, Bart Starr was not only a good and decent man, but he had a deep love for this community and helped form the Green Bay that we know and love today. So this is all to say, folks, that I'm proud and honored today in just a moment to sign Senate Bill 101 that designates the Walnut Street Bridge here in Green Bay as the Bart Starr Memorial Bridge. This bill is many years in the making, but I want to first of all say, and it's a bipartisan bill, which is always great, and I want to thank, however, a former senator, State Senator Dave Hansen, for championing this bill in the legislature for so many years. And I know Senator Wimberger is also with us today, and he's done a great job shepherding this, as well as from the outside, Mayor Gingrich and Executive Streckbeck. Sorry about that, Eric. Anyway, so with that, before I sign the bill, I'd like to hand things over to Green Bay Packers President and CEO Mark Murphy. Mark?
Good afternoon, and thank you all for coming out today. It's obviously a great event, but mostly I want to thank Governor Evers for choosing Lambeau Field for today's bill signing. Really couldn't be a better place given Bart's connection to Packers and Lambeau Field, and really honored to have you all here today. You know, on behalf of the Packers as well as the Starr family, Sherry and Bart Jr., I'd like to thank so many people made this possible. You know, the governor mentioned, Senator Hansen really got it started. But Green Bay Alderman Mark Stoyer was instrumental, and so many other city and community leaders really got this idea started. Also want to thank Mayor Gingrich and his team have been so supportive of this, really appreciate that. And also as well at the state level, I'd like to thank Representative Dave Steffen, and Senator, I know the governor mentioned, Senator Eric Wimberger and their colleagues in the legislature. It is great to see bipartisan work together, so it's great, and they not only authored but advanced the bill, and obviously big thanks to Governor Evers for signing it into law today. You know, the governor talked a little bit about Bart Starr. He just, what a remarkable man. You know, just a beloved figure in Packers history. You know, he epitomized for so many of our fans hard work, humility, leadership, excellence, and class. And here at Lambeau Field, what he accomplished here, and you heard the governor read them all, just remarkable what he was able to accomplish. And you think about it, what an amazing story. He was a 17th round draft pick. We haven't had 17 picks in, 17 rounds in the draft for years. But he earned everything, so humble. But, as he mentioned, he leading his team to 5 championships. But just as significant as what he did off the field. And he and Sherry were great partners, and they did so much in the community, not only here, but across the state. Obviously, Rawhide was a huge priority for him, and he was a champion not only on the field but of countless initiatives and of organizations and of people who need help, who worked hard, and he worked hard to help those less fortunate and make our community a better place. I feel very fortunate in my position. I had a great opportunity to get to know Bart, as humble as anybody you would meet. It was never any sense that he was entitled to special treatment, and it was always, what could he do to help the Packers? And just a great person. And he and Sherry, I often spoke of the remarkable people in this community and how much Green Bay meant, and the state of Wisconsin meant to them. They appreciated their time here so much and loved coming back. And I know that Sherry and Bart Jr. and the entire Starr family will greatly appreciate this tremendous honor. And we look forward, we're going to have at a game this fall, we'll have a ceremony to recognize officially the naming of Bart Starr Bridge, and really excited about it. And just again would add our thanks to Governor Evers and everybody else who made this possible today. And thank you again for everybody coming out. So with that, I will turn it back over to the governor.
Thanks again, Mark. And with that, it'll be my pleasure to sign Senate Bill 101, making it 2021, Wisconsin Act 74, and designating the Bart Starr Memorial Bridge forevermore. We have a few minutes for people that might have any questions. Any questions?
Go ahead. I want to present you to this. This is a book that was written by, that's what you get when you drop your cane. Thank you, Governor. Okay, hang on to it. We can both use it.
I'll try it out.
Yeah. Book called Our 351 Sons, and it's a story that has 15 different stories of the Starr family and their support of Jan and I with Rawhide. And there's one story in here, I put a tag in here on page 47, and it's, we had just started the Rawhide program, moved out there with a 3-year-old and a 7-year-old sons who were struggling. And several people said if you could only get Bart and Sherry Starr to help. And so I tried to find somebody that knew Bart Starr personally that could introduce us and give